Hello everyone, thank you for watching my videos. So in last video we discussed about WinAFL, and before that I had one video in which I talked about how do we fuzz our simple vulnerable C program using HonggFuzz. So this video is continuation to our fuzz with HonggFuzz series, and today I'm going to show you how do we check how a executable file is compiled using ASAN or not, how do we check it is compiled using UBSAN or not. So for that there is one set of utility comes which we call as a Pwntools. So that is a open source package, and it actually contains a lot of utilities which can be useful for exploit development, but today we are going to see only one of them, which is called checksec. So this utility, it allows us to check if an executable file is compiled using ASAN, UBSAN or not. And that will be actually very helpful, because what happens is that when we compile a file for fuzzing, we sometimes we forgot to add some flags like fsanitize address or fsanitize undefined. And in that case, if we start fuzzing and later on we come to know that we have not compiled it using ASAN, then there are chances that we might miss some of the crashes. So it's always better to check before we start our fuzzing process to see if the executable is compiled using ASAN, UBSAN and all kind of sanitizer which we wanted to use. So this utility actually is very helpful. And to install that, it is basically part of a Python package, so you can use pip command, and it's pretty simple. So as you can see, you can go to this website, you can simply do a Google search for Pwntools, that is pwntools, and you will come across this website, that is pwntools.com, and you can browse the menu over here, which actually gives you the installation instruction. So to install Pwntools, it's pretty simple. Just use this command, like that is python3-m, that is module pip, then install, and then you can simply use Pwntools. If you already have it installed, then you can use this upgrade command. Otherwise, you can skip this upgrade command, and you can simply use python3-m pip install Pwntools. So what it will do is it will install all the utilities which comes with Pwntools to your system, and it has certain dependencies which you need to install. So before installing Pwntools, you can install this utility is called python3-dev, jit libssl-dev, libffi-dev, build essential. So if you're not if you don't have these utilities installed over here, then simply run this command apt-get install then name of all the libs, and when you do that it will install Pwntools. So I will simply run this command on my system, and then we will see what happens. So the command is python pip install Pwntools. Actually it's python3. Okay, let's wait. So I have already installed it on my system, but when you run this command, you can see that it will install a couple of packages on your system. So it will take some time, and make sure that you are not behind the proxy, because if you are behind the proxy, then you need to change some data. You might need to install all this package manually, because I was having some issue with the proxy. So I actually ended up removing that, or I need to install a few of these packages like unicorn and all this thing to manually on my system. So after you install that, you can simply use a utility called checksec to check any executable file which you want to fuzz, and it will give you that if the program is compiled using ASAN or not. So let's have a simple output. So as you can see on the left hand side over here, we have our simple image read program which we are going to use in all of our fuzzing exercises. And so let's go and build it first without ASAN, and then we'll build with ASAN. So there is a simple command over here. The command to build is so we can use either HFuzz CLang, since we are fuzzing it with HongFuzz. So we can either use HFuzz CLang or we can use HFuzz GCC, whatever works for you. And then initially we will not use fsanitize address, that is address sanitizer, because we want to see if our binary is compiled with ASAN or not using checksec utility. So intentionally we are not compiling it using ASAN. So I added a G flag, so that will help us in debugging. It will generate symbol and everything, so that will be useful for debugging. So let's compile that. Okay, you can see that our program has been compiled successfully and the executable file name is img read. So let's go and check checksec img read. And let's see what output we get over here. So you can see that there is no mention of ASAN over here. It mentions UBSAN over here. So that is, I think, when you compile it, by default it comes with UBSAN. But there is no mention of ASAN over here. So let's go and compile it again using fsanitize address and see what happens. So I'm just adding the flag fsanitize is equal to address. And okay, it has been compiled. And let's again run this command, checksec image read. And as you can see, now it gives that ASAN is enabled over here for our binary. So in that way, you can check if any binary on Linux is compiled with ASAN, UBSAN, or what NX, that is non-executable, or all kind of flags over here. You can see the architecture and everything over here. So now that we have compiled our binary using ASAN, let's go in fuzz using HongFuzz, and then we'll see some crashes which HongFuzz find, and then we'll try to do a root cause analysis for one or two different crashes. So to fuzz with HongFuzz, we'll simply run this command again. That is HongFuzz I input, and it should be /img read file. Okay, I need to add -- over here. Okay, so it is working, and let's wait for some time and we hope that it will find some crashes. So let's see. So it is actually finding the crashes, but since I already run it previously, it is saying that all my crashes are duplicate, and now you see that it started finding unique crashes again. So let's wait for some more time and see. Total unique crashes are 5, 6, they are increasing. So let's wait for some more time and see what happens. Okay, 7. So you can see that total iterations are like around 1000 plus. That mode is feedback driven mode. So since we have compiled our binary using HFuzz CLang compiler, what it does, it adds some instrumentation code inside the binary. And at the runtime, it will check when it gives some input, it checks that if a particular input leads to a path, a new path or not. So if that is the case, then it will basically keep that input and it will go further with that. So you can see that our target command is this, that is image.img read and file. So at the runtime, it will remove the file with the actual file name. And threads, so basically there are one thread, but we can run multiple threads over here. And speed, you can see it varies from 0 to 34, 35 execution per second. Then you can see crashes, so that is total of 230 plus crashes, which is increasing. There are around 16 unique crashes, and timeout is 6, so there are 6 test cases which timeout, which did not respond in 1 second. and you can see that it's corpus size, so that is 24 and initialize 30 files. So there are actually 30 files inside input directory. Then coverage update, so it was like last coverage update was around 26 seconds up, above, and then it is showing coverage, so age, that is 4 out of 10, and compare coverage, that is 184. So since we have unique crashes of 19, let's go ahead and stop it and we will go and see some of the crashes. So when you do ls, you can see that all the crashes are saved in the current directory. You can actually change that if you want, but right now that is not our focus, so we are going to skip that and let's do some crash analysis again. So our command was img read, and then we will use fuzz crash and see what happens. So I just copy pasted the file and you can see that it is an heap buffer overflow and it is at line 73. So let's go and see in our source code what does line 73 contains. So on the left hand side you can see there is a source code. So on line 73 you can see it's a heap based buffer overflow where it's trying to read some data over here inside the out of bound read heap variable. And so let's go ahead and debug this crash to see what is the root cause over here. So I'm going to use GDB and we will trace the code. So the command is pretty simple. We will run GDB and we give our file name, that is gdb.imageread, and then r, and we'll give the file name and let's see. Okay, so we will put a breakpoint on imageread line since it is crashing at line 73. So let's go ahead and put a breakpoint over here and we will see what happens. So image 73 and I will run it again. So now we can see that our breakpoint has triggered and you can see that width is 61, height is 1 and buffer 1 is so on the left hand side you can see at the location 73 it is trying to read some data from buffer 4 from an offset size 1. So let's print size 1 first. So you can see that size 1 is actually 62 over here. So basically buffer 4 at offset 62, that is what it is trying to read. And so we need to check what is the size of buffer over here. And for that we need to backtrace that. So let's go ahead and see how this buffer 4 is getting allocated. So on the left hand side you can see that buffer 4 is getting allocated of amount size 3. So we actually need to check what is the size 3, and as you can see it contains only 61 bytes. So basically there is a 61 byte of buffer, and if you know over here, right, you can see that width is 61, height is 61, and on the left hand side of the code you can see how size 3 is getting calculated. So it is getting calculated over here like image width divided by image height. So what is getting what is happening here is that width, that is 61, is divided by height 1, so the result will be 61, and that size of buffer is getting allocated over here in malloc call. So that is what buffer 4 is. But what is actually happening is that at line 73 the buffer 4 at offset 62 is getting, that is one size more than it's actually allocated memory, and so that is why we are getting crash over here. So that is the root cause of this issue, And let's try and see if we have any new crashes so we can analyze that as well. And we'll see how do we find root cause of that. So I'm going to use second file now. And let's see what crashes it gives us. So you can see that it is giving a heap buffer overflow on address this, and this crash is occurring at memcopy function over here, which is called from process image function from line 39. So let's go and see in our code what is there at line 39. So if you go to line 39, you can see that there is a buffer one and the image data is getting copied over here. So size of buffer derived from image width plus image height over here. And as you can see over here, that image width and image height both are zero. So size one is actually zero, and so buffer is not getting allocated. And then you are trying to copy some data over here. So that is causing the same buffer overflow over here, because you are trying to copy some 10 bytes of data to the buffer one, which is actually not allocated. So that is why you are getting the crash. So this is the second crash.